Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Gridirons Recap, sponsored by the attorneys of Keller and Holland and Love Local at 53. I'm Dan Irons, out here at Garber High School, where the Hawks hosted TF South in the first round of the 7A Class A playoffs. I'm here with Jayshon Johnson, two touchdowns receiving tonight.
Blocked extra point.
Game-saving INT, right? This guy, Yashuris Pettis-Taylor, over 200 yards rushing as well. Jayshon, I'm going to ask you first, just talk about the halftime adjustments down 14-7.
The halftime, we were making the adjustments. The coaches had a great game plan and came out and executed. But in the first half, it was on us. We were missing tackles and beating ourselves. The O-line played great in the second half. We came out and we were able to establish a run game.
And this question is for you. You're like the Derrick Henry of high school football. You just warmed down in the second half. Just talk about this team, its composure, and battling the elements for the W.
Oh, we knew that we had to stick together at halftime and that keep out the rest. Great try to run. And all of mine, they're perfect. They came out and they just played high school football.
Perfect they were. They're on to the second round of the playoffs. Hey, let's check out all these highlights.
Opening round of the 7A playoffs, 7-2 Hoffman Estates hosting 6-3 TF South, matchup featuring two of the top rushers in the state. And Mother Nature reared her ugly head throughout this one. In other words, perfect football weather. First quarter, no score. TF South pinned at its own 15 and facing a 4th-and-10. They fake the punt and get the first. Major gamble pays off there. Hawks D would eventually hold them as the opening stanza ended 0-0. Midway through the second, TF gets something going thanks to the legs of Ernest Temple. Here he plows into the end zone from a yard out, and the visitors go up 6-0 with 6:22 left till intermission. That lead was short-lived, though, when just 32 seconds later, Aiden Sear connects with favorite target Jayshon. He's gone. Johnson, 53 yards for the house call as the Hawks zip ahead 7-6 with 5:50 left. Time winding down in the half, TF mounts another impressive drive, culminating in a Jacob Uradalis 1-yard QB sneak. The two-point conversion is good. Visitors back on top 14-7, and that was the score at intermission. Hoffman received the second half kickoff and, per usual, assembled a quick drive, matriculating down the field and in just 2 minutes. And at the TF South 15, Sear finds Sopkins sensation, Steven Sellers for 6, game knotted at 14 apiece. After a quick 3-and-out, Hawks begin another drive, but that boy Ernie, Ernest Temple, doing it on both sides of the ball, the pick 6 as he zigzags his way to pay dirt, 20-14 at that point, kick was blocked by Johnson, would that be a factor later on? Pick 6 in the rear view now. Hoffman counters with its bruising running back, Yashuris Pettis-Taylor, the Derrick Henry of the MSL West, wearing down defenders, scores on a 7-yard TD jaunt here, 21-20 late third. Would TF have an answer? Not so much in its next drive. Julian Bonilla and Eddie Latt, the sack, Hawks back in business, heading to the fourth. Hoffman gets the TF South 22, but then coughs it up on 3rd-and-inches. However, just seconds later, TF gives it right back on the turnover, and this time, the Hawks capitalize. 4th-and-5 from the 7, Sear fires a bullet that hits Johnson in stride, his second score of the evening, and it's 28-20 home team, 8:43 left to go. South wasn't finished, though. Uradalis, out of the gun, scrambles and heaves a prayer. His prayers would be answered as the ball caroms off defenders, and Brandon Woods never gives up on the play, corrals the pass for 6, 28-26 at 7 minutes to go. Now the TF defense was tasked with stopping the Hawks for a chance to forge ahead, but that's a tall order when the opponent has a bruiser like YPT, bulldozing defenders and helps the Hawks gain some breathing room when Sear finds Bonilla on a 2-yard TD pass. Extra point no good, 34-26 with 2:17 left, and left the door open for the visitors to send it to OT. South made a valiant effort and got deep into Hawks territory, but YTP, the exclamation point on the evening, the INT to end it, also finished with 200 yards rushing. Hoffman moving on to round number 2, and a hats off to a TF squad that never quit. Ernest Temple, 223 yards on the ground, a Herculean effort in defeat.
Well, hey, that's it from Hoffman Estates High School. For Gridirons, I'm Dan Irons.